Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to another video on CodeTutor. In the previous video, we have seen how to work with derived state of. In this video, we will concentrate on another new side effect, remember coroutine scope. Well, even before we attempt to understand how to use this, let's try to understand the scenario where this is useful. Let me go back to the screen that we had developed in the previous video. Here, let's slightly change this. What we will do is, we will remove the increase button and we will keep the decrease button, but instead of naming it as decrease, let's rename it as start counter. And then the start counter should only happen on click of the button, and when you do that, the counter value should start showing in the UI. Well, as soon as you hear the term start incrementing the counter, certain questions will have to definitely be answered. That is, how are we starting this particular counter? One is definitely on click of the button, and then since we are continuously incrementing the counter, we cannot do it on the UI thread, because if you do it on the UI thread, it is going to block the UI thread. That should give you some idea as to what could be the solution. We can use a coroutine to do that. But we also have to ensure that the counter need to be lifecycle aware. What do I mean by lifecycle aware? If you have been doing Android development, you might be aware that Android composables, UI components like activity fragments, they have lifecycle. So this coroutine should run within the scope of the lifecycle of the hosting composable. If the composable ends, the coroutine should stop. It cannot keep on running. That's the whole idea. Well, once you have the context of what we are trying to achieve, that is where the remember coroutine scope comes into picture to help us to achieve this. So let's get into a demo and see how this is done. So this is the same old code base where we have decrease and increase button. So what we will do is, first thing is, we will go here and remove this. This is not needed. And here there is a decrease button, and instead of calling it as decrease, let me call it as start counter. This functionality we will have to change, but what we will first do is we will write a coroutine. And how do we write a coroutine? Using the suspend function. If you are not familiar with what is a suspend function, what is a coroutine, we have covered all of these things as a part of the Kotlin fundamentals. So please go through that if you are not familiar with it, and then come back here to get a better understanding of how we are using the coroutine to demonstrate our idea here. So let me come here and let me write a suspend function. Let me call it as start counter. What it will take is, it will take a increment function. Let me pass a lambda here, and what it does is, for I in 1 to say 100, it will increment the counter, but this will be too fast, so let me add some delay here. Let me add a delay of 1 second. So that's the suspend function. Now I should be able to call this particular suspend function, but I can call this only in a coroutine scope. So I need a coroutine scope. So let me create a coroutine scope inside the composable. That is val coroutine scope is equal to remember coroutine scope. And then let me go to the click functionality here. That is here, and I will write coroutine scope dot launch, and within this particular coroutine scope I will basically call the start counter, and I will pass the increment counter, which is basically this lambda that we have implemented. So let me run this. UI wise this looks fine. Let me open the logcat. So counter is initialized and counter value in function is 0, and then I start the counter. I think I did a mistake here. It has to be a function. Let me start this thing again. You can see that the counter has started running and we are continuously seeing the counter value in the logcat. Now, if I click back, the counter should stop because you are basically closing the composable. That is what it means, that this coroutine needs to be lifecycle aware. So when I click back here, you will see that you are no more getting the logs of the counter. So what Remember Coroutine Scope allows you to do is run a coroutine explicitly, that is on click of a button, and run it such that it is lifecycle aware. If the composable that started that coroutine ends, then the coroutine ends. That's the whole idea. And what if the coroutine ends its course? That is also possible. That should not be a problem. So let me just reduce here and make it 10 and restart this. Let me click on the start counter and you will see that it will go up to 10 and then it will stop. So if the composable is visible, it will run its course and it will stop. But if it is a very long running task, then also it should not be a problem because we are using Remember Coroutine Scope. It basically allows you to not to worry about something running in the background continuously even when you have closed the screen. So you don't have to worry about the battery draining out. You don't have to worry about, let's say, trying to hit a backend even when the screen is closed. So you have basically optimized your coroutine such that it only runs when the composable is on. So that is where you use Remember Coroutine Scope. So that's it what I wanted to discuss in this video. In the next video, we will continue to explore this in much more detailed manner with respect to other side effects. So stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.